Welcome into OTR Elite 32 here at Mays High School. Marcus Burnett joined by Will Marlowe. We bring you this matchup featuring the Q6 All-Stars taking on Southern Stampede. It's a 6-2 advantage for the Q6 All-Stars on the line. They've experienced the momentum on the offensive end and defense like that, so they make sure that it stays on their side. It's number one, Rodney Chapman there on the pursuit.
Over San Antonio in June when they were playing that Monday and Wednesday game at the Miller Grove High School. Luke Caden has a good shot, but 2-6 right now, taking the 6-2 advantage, forcing tough shots on defense and been knocking down the shots on the offensive side.
Chapman from San Antonio High School, a great archive deal on SBC Media. Being a San Antonio High School team, they're taking on Miller Grove. He's a player you want to keep your eye on as well. Al Durham is number one there in the orange.
Yeah, Durham's standing at 6'4", class of 2017, attends Berkmar High School.
Ears must have been burning. Talk about Durham and the fact that you want to keep your eye on him throughout the game. Doesn't take long to be able to give you Exhibit A as he gets the and one there. Davis High School ball there at Berkmar. Berkmar, a squad that, those that have been in the Atlanta area for a while knows a lot about Wesley Witherspoon. Just one of the solid Westfield guys that come out of that Berkmar program. Witherspoon family as a whole, a very talented man. Wesley went on to play at Memphis. Played some professional ball as well. We also got Candy Witherspoon, who played D1 basketball a little bit over some ball. And the youngest Witherspoon as well. He keeps it back out. Now Dylan's going to try a three-point in and out on the shot. And now Paul Dines is going to go back over to Q6.
Durham got the shot he wanted, the open look. Just didn't knock it down.
Like you said, a good look. The Southern Stampede team coached by Al Durham Sr. And you'll never really see him get on his players for, for small stuff, like to let them play and do what they do.
He's what you call a coach. He's a players coach, right?
Anytime he's going to really get on you, now he's going to make sure you're learning the game and make sure your basketball IQ improves, but not going to sweat the small things. The only time he's going to really get annoyed or agitated is if he sees players not playing hard, which doesn't happen too often for this Southern Stampede program. He wants you to go for what you know, play hard, you'll be all right with both. By an extension of himself out there on the floor, out there in junior, he puts it over to the wing. Nice drive. They called the offensive foul there on that one.
And that could have gone either way right there. I thought it was a that's why they're getting paid down there. But still, a nice hard take there by number 4, Jay Esteemy. 6'5", shooting guard. Also attends Berkmar High School.
Yeah, Jay, that just looked like a good, strong move there. Not otherwise. So it's an 8-4 ball game.
The open look there by Rodney Chapman off the back of the iron, rebound there by number 4, Steve. I think that's another man we have to look out for. Number 32, Big Ben Martins Igbanu, the 6'9", 2016 point guard, power forward from Covenant Christian High School.
Combined with a name that's been buzzing around here, in and outside of the Peach State. Here in this travel season, Covenant Christian. Right there, just off of Fairgrounds there in the Marietta area. Known for producing hard players. Bonner definitely fits the mold. Looks like he'll be calling for steps there on that one.
We got number 5 and number 4, Jovan Rose, leading point. coming to Chapman.
Cook staying with the play and gets the easy layup on the other end.
Yeah, just like you said, you were talking good about Cook. Cook staying with the play right there. Initially turns it over trying to save it, but then he stays with the play, gets the ball back, and goes into the layup.
Didn't want no Cook. Just headed over to Bookmark. Was that at your cross last season? A lot in the playoffs here in the state of Georgia. And usually a lot earlier than they're supposed to when you look at their records going into the playoffs, but that's how the seeding can be across the state when you're talking turn time, so it kind of is what it is.
Yeah, Berkmar's going to be fun to watch with Zachary Cook, Durham, and Estimate. All of them on the court for starting. You know they're going to be starting too for Berkmar. Especially if they're transferring from Norcross, you know, there might be a little bad blood there, so.
You can always make for a good rivalry.
Oh, yeah.
One of the fun rivalries, you know, North Gwinnett versus Norcross, the ball was in the 10th. Chris Bolden, the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets, he played at Norcross and ended up transferring to North Gwinnett for a senior year. There were some very good games there in the House of Blue, as they called it, over at Norcross and Bolden. Hooks wide open for three. No good. Reinforcements coming in the form of the two-hand tip dunk. The spiffy jerseys by Stampede. Sometimes it takes a second to be able to see the number. Give me a second on that. Looks like 23. Keith Hurd. We heard you on that play, young fellow. Makes it 13-13 there with the tip dunk.
Yeah, Keith Hurd, 6'8", 2016. Shooting four out of Stanley Creek. Shady Creek, even known to the football program and the basketball programs, and they're coming around here.
That's definitely a good position. And it'll be head coach over there coming over tomorrow. We're talking about Christian Turner, one of the better and more underrated point guards in the state over there at Sandy Creek. And obviously, her trying to make some noise as well. So pay attention to those Patriots. The high school home of Big Megatron, Calvin Johnson. Sandy Creek, like you mentioned, known for those football exploits. Then again, that's the state, you know, that we live in right now. I'm primarily known for football, but I think the basketball paradigm is really shifting here in the Peach State in Atlanta specifically. A lot of attention here in Atlanta. Some calling it, you know, the mecca of basketball events when it comes to the South. Now, seeing that shift from Orlando to Atlanta being more of a destination when it comes to hosting.
Like you said, a bunch of these tournaments are starting to come to Atlanta, man.
Chapman just got on the floor. Chapman's going to go at it the entire game. You can have shot clock, three guard five, team like only another goal. And so to that, in the SBC archives, Chapman. Bringing that leadership on the floor and ability to score the ball and make plays for others here in this one as well. But it's a tie game. That team that returns that second gets it inside. It's got chains on the inside, so it comes to all stars the other way.
Yeah, nice look there. That's nice. It's going to be hard off the backboard.
To watch for Stampede is number 5, Zep Jasper. That's a place for Laney squad that went, I believe, 29-2 last year before losing the 2nd round in Morgan County there just before the Final Four. But a great season there for Laney. Coach Buck Harris taking the role down at Baldwin High School there in Millersville. So going from a program that went 29-2 to a program that I think maybe had one more than two in the win column last year. Coach taking on a challenge. Meanwhile, Jasper and Laney still have solid pieces there in Augusta. And we have fouled here. Colin Sexton goes over and touches base with Al Dunn.
Yeah, Baldwin Knights was that little Baldwin and John Mills down there. John Mills is proud of me, but Baldwin really kind of taking over John Mills, especially the go-to, the better basketball program. But it'll be interesting to see how that new face of Baldwin is.
Baldwin's the Braves, right?
Correct.
Sexton good on the first free throw.
14-13, 6 minutes, 22 seconds. Left to play here in the first half. Nice game. We go to the full court press here. Find the rock.
Go ahead, give him the ball so they can get it going. This is in the hands of Cook. Cook's the rest of the track. Now over to Durham. Durham, that's a lot of space for a guy that can shoot it like he can. He misses that one, though. So he gets that type of opportunity again. He won't hesitate to take it. Flat team. Tylon Patterson.
Yeah, nice driving dish there by Joe Von Rust. Quick 5'7" point guard. Out of Southwest Cab High School, dishes to Tylon Patterson under the basket. He finds himself at the line shooting for two.
Patterson, another Lithonia. Welcome to the here on this 2-6 All-Star squad.
A lot of different reasons why players
that's played with different teams. I think at the end of the day, as long as you're finding a way to get better, mix in AAU, tribal basketball, the skill development, it's a win-win situation. So, do you, regardless of the color of the jersey, get better. And that's what a lot of these players are out here doing in front of a full row of college coaches right on the base.
Trevor
Ariza,
again, going back-to-back from All-Stars, taking a 21-15 lead here. 37 left in the first half.
True basketball heads can appreciate going to a Covenant Christian. It's right here adjacent to the church. The Covenant Christian Ministries Academy right there. Very grassroots setting. Great hospitality. It's it's one of those places we love covering the different venues that we cover to broadcast events. It's one of those to where you can go out of bounds and have somebody hand you the basketball and then give you a high five while you're reaching out of your seat. But it makes for a very great atmosphere because the school really rallies around the team. And not only that, they bring in some very talented teams to play against Covenant Christian. So players like Martin Zabagnu and Banu are no new thing out of that program over there at Covenant. Protecting the ball, missing the first one, working hard to create another opportunity. Has that been blocked? Third time to turn.
Yeah, 12, Dennis Summer, 6-4, team guard, team fast passing,
Jeff Jasper with the assist of Jay Estimate, opening number 4, Jeff number 5. Talk about Jasper earlier. He's clear to keep your eye on him, but he won't put up the gaudiest point number. Not that he can't score, but he can play a safe guard in that way. Likes to play out of the situation. He's going to play hard movement, like you see them playing there on that play. There's some contact going out of bounds. But the calling card for Lonnie Squad last year was 4-5 players just like Jasper. Break the defense down and get that dime asked. Close up on the inside, you know, seeing why they're going to him at a higher frequency here over the past few possessions.
Yeah, you know, Bonu standing at 6'9". You don't really want one player for P6 that really comes close to that. It's 6'8", Benjamin Hayden. Other than that, they have a couple 6'6 guys. But Bonu really, he's really exerting his force in the highlight, especially saw that man play right there.
This tall, you can tell that young fellas, no stranger to the meat and potatoes either. Got some weight to throw around in there. Like you saw there on that last play, here's Chapman. Maybe a little too unselfish there on that one, but right at the rim, tries to drop it down. Teammates in a tough position. Had that one not gotten knocked out of bounds, it's probably going to get blocked. On the inside. It's a little defensive place where they play good defense, and then it just opponents have been one of the, you know, one of those options.
Right, or he gets himself a free throw.
Speaking of getting to the free throw line, that's what Chatton is doing here.
Man, I just can't wait to see what Dunn High School players do, especially Ronnie Chapman and Josh McCovey. See if they can knock off him in the road. He's won 6 of the past 7 state championships. So definitely fun to watch down the Dunn, the battle between the Dunn High and Miller Grove High School.
That will be a good one. And that's always fun because Miller Grove has been, you know, not just a representative for the Sony over here, but just Atlanta basketball as a whole. Those 6 state championships, they've really kind of been the poster boy for the area, or one of them. You know, you got programs like North Caldwell and several others that are well known as well. But, you know, there, you know, like on your high school, really coast to coast. Finishing there is Denzel Mahoney.
Looks like Nike 7 Stampede right here is going to hold for the last shot. 22 ticks and counting left on the clock. 25, 22, 26, All-Star lead.
Holding for the last shot here. 10 seconds on the clock. This is a shot. A lot of Orange jerseys flying around like ninjas on the inside, but time will run out before they can make good on that offensive rebound. So we'll take a quick break for halftime. When we get back, more On the Radar Hoops. 32 cover.
Yeah, it's right.
Oh, Southern Stampede has a Twitter. I didn't know that. Why do they have Nike twice? So, like, Nike Southern Stampede, Nike Elite Youth Travel Basketball Program. So, like...
They're Nike sponsored, and then they're in the Elite.
Okay. Gotcha. See, I like it when it's easy to find all of them. They all came up.
Thank you. second half action.
It's about to start. It's like the officials are touching base on who gets the ball to start the second half.
Second half is underway here. The Knights of Southern Stampede. Starting off here, number 5. Zephariah Jasper. Leading at a point. Once again, Stampede's trying to get it down to the big man, number 32, Bonnie. Who, according to ESPN recruiting, is the 35th best player out of his position nationally and 13th best player in the state of Georgia.
Basketball IQ and being able to be better players at the current level, but also the next level. But went ahead, let that play continue to go on, or you know, just say whatever you need to say. But you know, really saw it as a coaching moment right then and there to stop nipping in the bud and go from there.
Is up and away for Jasper. No good ball tipped around a little bit. Around there by K6. And Lord came all the way just to Chapman. And he caught an offensive foul, and Mike just didn't please to have it. Saturday in Sanford. Give you a few seconds to 29 to the lead.
The ball system will definitely increase. Nobody in the travel.
Chapman's got to fill up the open three ball. No good rebound there by Nike Southern Stampede. Trying to push it. Here's it off the ground.
Good job using that off arm without extending it too much to where it can fall for the offensive ground.
Right, and that's kind of, you know, what people are saying, you know, that just kind of comes natural to some of these guys. You can't really teach that too much. It's just one of those things where you're, when you're in the air and it just kind of comes natural to you. Shooting forward, class of 2016 at Dr. Phillips High School down in Orlando, Florida. Second free throw is up, and he's good there, rebounded by 17 feet. 2-6 continuing on that man-to-man defense. It's just such a great attribute for Zachary Quick. Because once he gets in the lane, for some of these big men, it's really hard for one of them, especially when he drives up to the basket, it's really hard for him not to draw the foul. And these big men kind of have to come and like arm bar him down at the basket. So Zachary Quick finds himself at the line going up there for two.
Now, obviously, in terms of girth, your average, you know, NFL running back is going to be a lot bigger than, you know, than a high school guard, but you look at it from a standpoint of some of the running backs that maybe aren't as tall or as large as others, and sometimes it's hard for the linemen and the linebackers to be able to find them until after they're already through that line and running upfield. And I think the same, similar dynamics can be at play here on the basketball court as well, because, you know, Cook can take advantage of certain nooks and crannies that a player that's larger might not be able to take advantage of.
Right. Great defense there by Cook, forcing rebound there by number 32, the big man, Vaughn here for a nice Southern Stampede. Finds Cook there in the corner, gets it back out to Durham.
Vaughn, you're going to go to work when he's going to feed. I'll Cook, keep scoring three. No good on the shot. Rebound there in the traffic by Denzel Mahoney.
That's what we were noting to earlier. Bono gets the ball down low. Body's crashed to him. Picks it out to Zachary Cook for open threes. You know, they're not all going to fall. Especially at the top, some of these guys are showcasing out here. You never want to give anyone an open three out here.
Yep.
30-29, Stampede back on top here. 12-12, up and going. Chapman with the floater in the lane, and it's good. Nothing but net for Chapman.
Chapman with the floater game. You see that? Last season, and also going into the summer, SBC broadcast the State Classic there over at Westlake High School. Remember, Lithonia was victorious there. Over Coach Darren Rogers and the Westlake Lions. Chapman was part of that championship run there in that tournament. That's got the base to get off the 6-8. Hook! Ice cream from the corner.
Yeah, right here, right back in the corner. You have to find yourself in another open look. You knocked it down this time. Tie ball game here. Chapman running point right now for 2-6. Green's going to come set up to him. He tells big man number 12 to get down low. Ball's fumbled around a little bit. He's out there with number 13 for 2-6. Christian Shorter, 6-5, 2-15. Ronald High School shooting guard, 2-42.
He's going to be bringing with us in the school this practice in just a couple moments ago. They have 2-6 also. Normally the white jerseys are the home team. For the sake of how the score is being kept in this game, home team is stamped on the scoreboard. The Wizards are the 2-6 also. They currently lead by 2.
It looks like number 1, Ajami Durham, for Nike 7 Stampede, has a little banged up knee, got rubbed out. This is probably one of those stingers, got rubbed out for a second. He's actually out of the game.
Yeah, he's going to be out for long.
Yeah, no way. Nice pass there for Q6, comes with the 12. He's on the hook and the hook, the hook, good rebound, it's such a
looks like pretty good defense there by Chapman on that one. I can give Estimate credit for it. I was talking about this on the webcast yesterday. Can effectively get the benefit of the doubt on the call. If you go in timid, suspect, as they would like to say, then a lot of times you're going to get treated as such, not only by the defender, but the official in terms of the call as well. That's when they went there powered up, went in strong, and they would get the benefit of the doubt put on that call.
No doubt.
But appreciate Chapman and the way he, you know, he went for the ball there in a way that was, you know, it was a reasonable foul. A lot of times you see a player foul, yeah, you don't want to give up anything easy, but you also want to commit a foul that allows you to possibly go for the ball and get a clean strike, or be able to come low without just coughing the foul up. Durham stampede on. The official knows that he caught up the 5-second violation there on the other end.
Yeah, stay tuned to this. We got plenty of action going up all throughout this afternoon here at Mains High School.
Getting to both of these
these teams, this high-intensity basketball game.
Changes a couple pleasantries with our college section on the way to the line. Love to see it, section. Taking it personal out there, really. Trying to make sure he minimizes Chapman's effect on the offensive end. Chapman still playing within himself, attacking, but not turning it into one-on-one ball.
Sexton on the D right there. While we had the ball, he knew where he was going to do, what he was going to do with that ball and take it off the ground.
Hey, talk about Chapman. Sexton. Sexton's a player that is very hard to stand in front of as well.
Bobby forcing the turnover down. Johnny Durham, 6'4", shoot point guard for 97 Stampedes back in the game after he had banged up a couple of minutes ago. Looks like that knee is not bothering him anymore, and he's good to go. Second three times back and get it back in the got down number 23, Keith Hurd. Southern Stampede's coming to the game for Bonnie. Bonnie's taking off a little banged up knee right now. Looks like he had a little stinger trying to walk it off. Gotta get back in the game though for Southern Stampede. They need the big man down by five right now. Chapman taking it hard to the basket, loses control. Fumbled around a little bit, regains possession, hands it off to one of his teammates. Don't help him at 2-1. Great play there by Chapman. Quick with the ball, laying on the ground, dishes it to number 23 for Q6, Justin Tucker. Tucker's going to go up to line for an and one. The free throw is up and good there for Q6. Nike's going up for the alley-oop, but no good there. Great decision making there for Nike Southern Stampede. The alley-oop was there, but it just goes off the rim. That was number 10, Jatari Smith, a 6'5", 2017 shooting guard out of Eaton Smith High School. The ball goes out of bounds, and he's going to get it back to Q60. Zachary Cook starting, Rodney Chapman right now. Nice pass by Chapman, foul number 23, Justin Tucker yet again in the basket. Chapman and Tucker has been a really good asset right now for Q6. Down late in the stretch of his game. Tucker been knocking down his free throws all game. Got two or four more right here. First one's no good. Looks like that's game we're going on to the game right now. Tucker still has another free throw here. Second one up is up and good. Zachary Cook right here. He's off the board. He tries to take it hard to the lane. The ball rolls around the rim. And oh, no good there. But Tucker's Jeremy's going to go to the line for two. Nice drive there by number one, Ajami Durham from Nike Southern Stampede. Ajami Durham Jr., might I add, is coach Ajami Durham Sr., coach of Nike Southern Stampede. Q6 taking a 25-22 lead in halftime, improving it to 45-37. They've been a pretty tight, close game all game. And I expect to save down the finish. Zachary Cook picking up 2 picks with Chapman full court. Chapman gets by him. This is off the number 32. Christian Schroeder down under the bucket. Goes up to an easy bunny. Chapman's clicking. He's really having a lot of touches. Q6 posted a charge on Durham. That's number 32, Christian Schroeder, yet again. Coming up big for Q6 All-Stars and me. Rodney Chapman, PointyRivals.com, won an offer from Arkansas State and Stanford. 2016 point guard. We know those are going to boost a little bit. Justin Tucker taking hard to the line. Going up for the line. Last contact, no foul. Like that, Q6 find themselves in a 11-point lead here late in the game. The easy bunny is missed, but Mike Southern State team keeps with it. Chapman slots it yet again, but gets called for another foul to the dismay of these Q6 fans. Right. time for two. Number 23, Keith Curry, out of center field, but he just checked into the ball game. Christian Short is a 6'5 shooting forward out of Arnold High School, who had just graduated this past semester out of Panama City, Florida. The second free throw is up and good. 51-39 lead. Since Igbonio left the game, Q6 had just been taking it hard to the rack, going to the line with no Igbonio down there. Timeout on the floor right here. Igbonio went into the huddle right now. It doesn't look like we might not see him for at least a couple more minutes, but next is going to be
temporarily, but how would you sum would you give them for why it's a 12-point advantage now for the Houston All-Stars?
Well, we're
talking
about 10 minutes left in the second half, and Martin and Bobby, and it looks like they're one of the games I knew all about the court for, and all of a sudden it's going to kind of look like they're trying to run their fingers when they're only out for a minute or two. But yeah, just recently checked back into the game, right when he was out, Q6 went on a 10-yard run, and just like that, and paid it to a 5-point lead. And ever since then, it's kind of been around a 10-11, 12-point lead advantage for the Q6. And with the Bonnie back on the floor, you know, not, it's getting strong early, and that's the time to keep the hard drive there by number 12. Colin Sexton's going to get to the line. You can never count any of these teams out here, but Q6, just in a matter of a couple, 4 or 5 minutes, that improved their advantage tremendously.
Especially not in this setting. I mean, you'll see teams, you know, be small with the ball, but you know, in this setting, you're not really going to see teams just spread out and just drain clock. You know, it's going to still be an up and down pace, even though I'm sure you'll see some game management on behalf of the Q6 All-Stars. There's plenty of time left, just under 5 minutes, 4:51 remaining. If Stampede wants to make a move, it would be good for them to have a Stampede on the offensive end and try to see if they can close this gap. Throws or freebies, your best friend here over the next couple minutes.
Yeah, that freebies are really hurting my position. I think he's going to fall right in the second half. And that's the top of the last three points here. Lucky's got it.
Track, you don't want to fall into it. Q6, you're trying to run a little bit of clock. They sub Rodney Chapman right back into the game, but you don't want to get to a point to where it's more about the stall and the moving around the running clock to where if such a Stampede rattles off a couple buckets, you want to try to turn the offense back on, but you're going in the stall and delay mode, and it's hard to sometimes get these jumps out of there.
Right, you know, if you play not to lose, that's when some of these mishaps start happening, and you know, if you play to lose the game. Like, you gotta play the full game. If you play about the lose, you know, that's when you might see some of these mishaps start happening. And like you said, Stampede might be having those. But like you said, going to Stampede, you're at the game.
You know, it's all about personal preference. Obviously, if there are best practices, coaches are going to, you know, want their team to be smart and try to finish out a game. But I'm of the Steve Spurrier approach, you know, back when he was at Florida, man. Hey, look, let's just air it out, keep, you know, keep the foot on the throat, keep it moving. Not to the point where it's unwise. To it, letting them get momentum, and then we drop from our feeding to me. Someone kicks it out. A shot. Good, Tucker with the rebound. Pulls it out of there. Gets it ahead. Tucker loses the handle.
Out of this, or not going to keep up, and see if they can get some quick buckets and some stops.
I got news for you, they're not going anywhere anytime soon. You got to be able to close it at the free throw line. That trip is not a good reflection of that.
The good news for Q6 is Tyler Patterson's back on the bench there. After going down with a knee injury, he's trying to force the steal, he's going the other way. Hesitation near the bucket. Misses the lay-in. Rebound there. And now for the end for number 23, Justin Tucker.
Tucker had Chapman's back on that one. Chapman was a little bit too Sexton focused on where Sexton was to where he focused more on Sexton's positioning, Michael just finishing the layup. And we had a backup plan. And then we talked about it.
You can just barely see that at the top of your screen right now. Second free throw is up and no good. Tyson Ward missing both free throws. Michael Southern State he's going to have to capitalize off that. Aaron Pass is tipped out of bounds. It's going to stay on the ball. Martins and Bodney on the bench right now. Bucket there by Jatori Smith going up strong, getting 2 points. 9 point lead right now for Q6 at 145 and counting after the game.
Caught that one with Kirk Gavin with as well. Brings it to within 9. Will it be too little too late? They need to stop here. But Justin Tucker said no serve.
Justin Tucker and Christian Ford have a huge impact on that for Q6 in the second half. Looks like Smith's going to draw a blocking shot. He's going to head to the line for 2 more. It's using his power and stick. Score is a little lopsided to what we really see so far in this game. It's really been a tight game here. And real tight competitive game. The score just got a little out of hand. But, you know, still, 9-point advantage. You know, Reggie Miller did it against the Knicks. So, why can't someone can't do it here?
Yeah, it was one of those times. It just hasn't been able to mesh well where they get those two working, you know, in a sequence that allows them to close this gap. 9 points isn't an insurmountable deficit by any means, but when you trade baskets or you try to get a score after a stop, it's going to be something that's going to be enough. Be sick if Chapman gets that way.
Yeah, push a foul, and get the basket, and make it 17 feet. You can get it back to 3-6, and they're going to go to 9 for the right hand. Tyson Rose, keep in mind. Give him another one. This one's up and good. Second one's no good. Rebound there by Smith. Finds Durham on the corner of the wing.
Or just out there on the floor handling the ball, making sure that this stampede pressure doesn't create the turnovers that it's intended for. And you can definitely see how the team is better when coming out there on the floor.
No doubt. It's going to go in the second half, really kind of taking over, taking control. And, you know, it's been a real contributor to why Justin Tucker and Christian Shores had such a great second half. You know, Rodney Chapman's been able to get in the lane. He's been able to dish it to one of those big men under the basket. He's taken hard to the back and gone to the line and taken the two buckets. But he's also been a pretty good shooter there, too. Those three players have been good for Chapman. Like you said, he does have hold offers right now from Arkansas State and Sanford, but they will. The offers will come. He's going to be full force for him with his senior year coaching. Three balls up and good there for number four, Jay Estimate. Ward, the 6'4 guard out of Tampa Prep, down in Dakota Rock, Rusty, Florida. Ward misses the front end of 1-1. Sexton falls off a deep three ball off the front of the line. 6'6 and gets a better rebound. Got charged to the bucket and misses. Rebound there by number 0, Trevor Lucio. And what was a tight ball game opened up down the stretch behind Robert Chapman, Christian Shorter, and Justin Tucker, among others. But nevertheless, P6 takes this one 62-51. Stay tuned. We have another tip off here coming up shortly in around 2 minutes. You're watching SEV TV.